All right, it's finally time to start modeling our house. The first thing we're going to do is set dimensions. The best way to control the distance between the walls you want is with dimensions. I can always select it and use the arrow keys and tab over. I can drag, but the best way to actually keep your project accurate is to do it with dimensions. Now, there's always debate about how you should correctly dimension your plans. The two main things you hear are either dimension to the stud or dimension to the finished surface. In this course, we're going to dimension always to the stud, and the reason I think that's the way to go is because you want to dimension, you want your plans to be drawn to the trade who's going to be looking at them. And so the first guys on your site who are going to be building these walls are your framers, right? And so you want to give them dimensions that they can use without having to look at the finish and subtract a finish, right? So if I say a wall is 20 feet from another wall and I'm dimensioning to the finish, then the guys in the field have to figure out what that finish is, subtract that dimension, and it's easier if you just give them a dimension they can work with directly. So I'm going to always dimension to the face of the stud, either the outside or the inside face of the stud. Remember when we built our wall, we kept only the stud in the core, right? And here's one of the ways that's going to help us out. To create a dimension, I'm going to launch my command by hitting DI, and if I come up here to the place dimensions, by default I think it says wall center lines, and I'm going to change it to face of core. That's just going to help us go a little bit faster. You can see as I hover over the wall, the first thing it wants to jump to is the core. That blue line right there is what Revit will dimension to when I left click. You can see you can hover over different areas and it'll select different layers of the wall. Here it's selecting the exterior finish, here it's selecting the core, there's the center line, there's the other core, there's the interior finish. If you're not getting what you want, you can always tab over, but since I set it to core, it's going to quickly jump to that face of the core. The first dimension I want to set is going to be my overall dimension. It's going to go all the way from this wall all the way to that wall. And since we want this wall and that wall, we can just get any sort of chunk of the wall right here. You always want to avoid trying to dimension directly in the corners, because you might get the actual corner, you might get some part of the wall join. So if I want to dimension this wall, I can get anywhere along this wall. So I'm just going to get a nice meaty portion of the wall. You can see I've got the stud highlighted. If I left click, I'll scroll out, I'll come over here, and there's the other stud. I'll drag up here and I'll click off to the side. You see my walls are now 54, 9, and 3/32 inches, right? So we're never going to dimension to a 32nd. The smallest dimension would be maybe an eighth. In this course, I don't think we're going to have anything more than a quarter or a half an inch. And so to set the dimension correctly, what we want to do is move one of these walls. And what we're going to have to do is basically set a datum. So we're just going to say that this wall is in the perfect location, and this wall is in the perfect location. So as we move these walls around, we're not going to move this one, and we're not going to move this one. So if I select this wall, you can see my dimension turns blue. I can do a single click on it, and I'm just going to type in 56, because I know that I want my overall dimension to be 56 feet. The reason we do this is that now every other dimension on the inside can add up to 56. It can all even out. So I'm going to repeat that process on all sides. So if I hit DI, I'm going to get the stud, I'll get the other stud, I'll drag down here, and I'll do the same thing on the left and the right. And you can see I don't really have to zoom in to see what I'm looking at, because I know it's going to get the face of the core. And I know that I want this dimension from this wall to that wall to be 28 feet, and since I said I'm going to keep this one in place, I'll select this one, I'll zoom in, and I'll type in 28. Click off to the side, and there you go. If for some reason, let me just set up an example. Let's say you've got your dimension, and you select the wall, and nothing happens. That means that dimension is not actually going to the wall. You can see I just drew a little line in here, and that can happen sometimes. You can dimension something close to the wall by accident. So if you want to move an object that you think has a dimension to it, you select it, and that dimension doesn't turn blue, that means you don't actually have that item selected. So what we're going to do, we can select the dimension. You get these two leaders. The leader closer to the wall is just visual purposes only. You can drag it to get the look that you want, if you want to hold the leader off the wall or have it go directly into it. And this one, this inner leader, is the one that actually sets the dimension. So if I'm only changing one, I can select it and drag over to what I want, and now that one's snapped back to the wall. If I select my wall, you can see it turns blue. The other common mistake people do is they forget to select their wall, and so they'll just click on this, and this will bring up a different menu where you can add information. We'll talk about this a little bit later, but the way to move your wall is set your dimension correctly, select the wall, and then single click on the dimension and type in the value that you want. Another note about dimensions with Revit, you don't have to type in the feet and inches symbol, which is really nice. So if I want this to be 57 feet 6 inches, I just do 57 space 6, hit enter, and it moves. I could also do 57.5, and it knows. If I want that to be inches, I can just do 0 space 9, it'll be 9 inches. So we've created our exterior dimensions, our overall dimensions. This will square up our project. The next thing we want to do is create our building break dimensions, and that's going to be basically anywhere you've got a 90 degree turn. That's because this wall is going to be constructed as one piece and tilted up. This wall is going to be constructed as one piece and tilted up. So you want to give them that actual dimension. So we'll repeat our process. We'll hit DI. I'll make sure I get the outside face of my stud. I'll come to this outside face of stud, and then I'll come to this outside face of stud. And here you see again, we got that weird 38, 11, and 19 32nds dimensions. But we know that the overall is going to add up. So when I correct this, when I correct this wall to what I want these two distances to be, it'll add up to 57.6 as a nice whole number. It does right now, but we don't want this 32nd fraction. Let me add the rest of the dimensions first so we can see this process work on both sides. Okay, so I've got my overall dimensions set. Let me move this back to 56, which is what we wanted. So now I'm going to start to square up the project with the other dimensions I want. I want this wall right here to be 36 feet long. Since I said I'm going to keep this one in place and this one in place, I'll select this wall right here. You can see my dimension string turns blue. And I'll just single click on it, type 36. That becomes 36. That becomes 20 with what I want. I want this sort of entry pathway right here to be 8 feet. So if I select that wall, the 6-foot dimension turns blue, I'll type in 8, and I get what I want. This side is a little bit weird. What I want is this stud to be perfectly in alignment as I come across. Of course, you see that on this side, the outside of the stud is closer to the wall, and on this side, the outside of the stud is further from the wall. So there's a couple of things I can do here. I think the align tool will work well. So if I hit AL, I launch my align command, and what this is going to do is allow me to align multiple objects. So I'll select the first object that I'm using as my baseline, and I want to zoom in, and I want to make sure that the studs are in alignment. So I'll pick either face of the stud, which will be this line right here. I tabbed over, I'll left click. Now if I scroll up here, I want to hit that same face of the stud, so I'll tab until I get it, I'll click, and now it goes into alignment. You can see it changed the dimension, because if a dimension is set to an object, it'll automatically change with it if you move it, which is really nice. So let's get that back into alignment. So now those are in alignment, it updated the dimension. I can show you with the detail line. I hit DL to draw a detail line. I'll draw my drafting line in here. Alright, so you can see that those studs are nice in alignment. That's going to help me keep my interior wall straight when I start to model my interior walls next. Alright, while the video was paused, I changed one last dimension. This wall right here, I wanted that to be 24 feet apart, and I spent a little bit of time cleaning up your dimensions. One thing is that I didn't want when they came in, they basically were snapped all the way to the wall, and I don't really want my dimension strings to cross as much as possible, so if I select this dimension, I can change the leaders, and I just drag them out a little bit so that they don't go into the wall, they don't cross each other. Just like if you're in architecture school, you know, it takes time to create your final presentation, you have to do your design, then you have to spend actual time doing production of your boards and such. Same thing with your construction documents. So I can set those dimensions, but you're not going to get them perfectly organized and neat the first time. So you have to spend time creating them. You also have to spend time making your actual drawings look cleaner, look a little bit more professional.